Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at one of the new features in DaVinci Resolve 18.6. It is the ability to load up your footage from your camera if you're using the newly announced Blackmagic camera app on your iPhone, or if you have a Ursa G2 connected to an iPhone, that can work as well. This feature, of course, may come to other cameras in the future. I do hope it'll come to all of them. It is the ability to actually shoot footage and make it upload directly into DaVinci Resolve. And in this video, I'll just quickly show you how to set that thing up. So without further ado, let's just jump right into DaVinci Resolve. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve. First off, we are going to create a new project. I already did create it, but we are going to save it a little bit differently so the things actually will work. So first off, when we are going to save a project or starting a project, we're going to have this new splash screen right here. And here I'm going to name my project. And I'll go into choose location for your project media. I'm going to leave it as it is. And then for the third one, we are going to share project with multiple users. And here we can put in either a single user or we can do this with the multiple users. And I'm going to change this into multiple users, even though I'm a one-man band, but we are going to do that because this is the way you would set it up if more people were working on your project. So now we go into the synchronization storage with Blackmagic Cloud. So to make this work, actually, you need to have the Blackmagic project server, and I do have that. That is $5 a month, and that's super useful if you're doing videos like I do, and I can do that at home or at the office. It doesn't really matter. So anyway, for this here, we are going to sync proxies and originals. We're going to toggle on here, and for the fifth one, we're going to allow remote camera access, and I'm going to allow that, and we're simply just going to push save. So now the project is being saved. Next thing to do would be to log into Blackmagic Cloud and have a look at the settings. Okay, so first off, we're just going to log into Blackmagic Cloud. If we go into the settings of the Blackmagic Cloud, we can now see that we have 2 GB of storage, which is absolutely free. That's a free one. And then we have different pricing. You can see here, if we go to 500 gigabytes, it's $15 a month. And then we, of course, can go to 1,000. I don't even know what that is, but that is like $30,000 a month. And I'm definitely not going to go to that project. But what we can do with this plan here, with the 2 gigs, we can actually have two. We can only have 2 members if you do the free plan. If you go to the 500 gigs, you can have 30 members in your project, which is kind of cool. I do wish they had like a middle ground thing, because I think like 2 terabytes is $60 a month. That's a bit expensive. I would have wished they had like a 1 terabyte. But, you know, $15 a month, that's not too bad. But for this demonstration, we are just going to use the 2 gig and free one. So I'm just going to push continue. Plan has changed. Confirm. It's free. Yes, it is. And of course, you can change this plan every month as you want. So let's just jump into the camera, because there's some things we need to set up as well. Okay, so here I have my iPhone and I have my apps. We're just going to jump into that and see how we're going to set this up. So first off, we are going to go to the settings. And in this case, I'm just going to change the codec resolution for what I want. Let's just, for this video here, let's go to ProRes LT and go back here, and also need to go into the settings and change some stuff around. So if I go down here to the Blackmagic Cloud settings, you need to be logged into the Blackmagic Cloud, and you can see I am that. And then I have my cup video, and that is the video I'm doing now, and that should be just fine. So everything should be fine, and I'll just go into the camera here, and let's just change stuff around here. I'm just going to do a quick shot to see if it works. So let's just quickly change the lens to the front-facing camera here. So what we're going to do here, we're just going to do a quick shot of me here. So let's try that. I'm just going to push the record button and it's just going to record a very quick clip. And I'm just going to stop that and I'll go into the media and here we have the clip. So in theory, we are going to select this and we can push the upload button. And I want to put this into the cup video and private storage. And I'm going to hit upload. And inside of DaVinci Resolve, a new folder is going to appear with camera uploads. And if we take a look into that, we can see we have here the uploaded file and we can put that down to our timeline and start editing. So let's just jump out to the studio and do a little sequence of clips that we're going to upload into DaVinci Resolve and then I'll show you how that looks later on. Okay, so now we're just going to shoot some clips with the app and we're going to shoot some clips with this cup. Going to make some kind of a little commercial using this plastic cup. So we are going to start with doing a little punch in shot here on a skateboard dolly and we're just going to do a little push in shot. Basically just using the app and the autofocus function. So let's do that. Okay, so now we've done multiple shots using the iPhone. And if you want to know more about how the camera works, you can take a look at this video right up here or here, wherever it is on the screen. I run more through the different settings and stuff and how the app works. So have a look at that. And we're just going to go in and have a look at how the files are syncing up inside of DaVinci Resolve. So here again, back in DaVinci Resolve, I pushed upload and I did a thing around 12, 14 different shots and it actually loaded in super fast and it is a very nice workflow. So as you see, you can easily work like this and create some kind of cool content. I think this is a nice feature in DaVinci Resolve. Okay, so that is how you set up the app to upload directly into DaVinci Resolve 18.6. And here is the edit of the footage I did. So anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.